Radiotherapy is a medical application in nuclear physics, where we irradiate diseased tissue cells with beams of particles. There are several different types of radiotherapy, but today I'm going to talk to you about proton therapy. That's where we use a beam of protons to irradiate diseased tissue, for example, a cancerous tumour. Tissue cells in our bodies are made up of molecules. If we zoom in on a molecule, we will see that it is simply when a group of atoms are bonded together. Now, if we zoom in on that atom as well, we will see in the very center a nucleus, and orbiting around are negatively charged electrons. Protons have a positive electric charge. You probably already know that when we have a positive charged particle and a negatively charged particle, they are attracted to one another. So when a proton from our proton beam comes close to the atom, it can drag away some of those negatively charged electrons. And we call that process ionization. Ionization damages the molecules inside tissue cells. When DNA is damaged, the cell cannot work properly. More importantly, it cannot replicate and therefore can't multiply. So one way to treat cancer is to fire a beam of protons at the cancerous tissue. The ionization damages those cancerous cells and stops them from multiplying any further. But there's a problem. What is to stop the beam of protons damaging healthy tissues as well as the diseased ones? This is where we use a property of proton radiation called penetration distance. You've probably heard of X-rays. They're a type of radiation made up of photons of light. They ionize atoms and damage the tissue all the way along their path, making it difficult to avoid those healthy tissue cells. So to kill cancer cells with X-rays, we have to overlap beams from several different directions. That way, the cancer cells get enough exposure to suffer damage, but the healthy cells only get a low dose. But protons do most of their damage over a small distance and then stop. We call this the penetration distance. This prevents them from damaging healthy tissue cells further along their path. Now here's the really important part. This penetration distance is dependent on the energy of the proton beam. By carefully selecting this energy, we can choose how far into the body the proton does its work before stopping. We can accurately target the protons to cause maximum damage to the disease cells while causing as little damage as possible to those healthy cells. To produce a beam of energetic protons, we first need a source of protons. The simplest source is hydrogen. It's just a proton and an electron. And we can use an electric field to strip off those electrons, leaving just a proton behind. To get the protons to high energies, we need to accelerate them. There are two main ways we do this: a cyclotron or a synchrotron. Both methods use an electric field to accelerate the protons and a magnetic field to guide them. Cyclotrons gradually accelerate protons in a spiral path, getting closer to the outside edge until they are ready to be extracted. Cyclotrons are great at producing a large, continuous current of protons, but they can only produce it of a fixed energy. Synchrotrons guide the protons around in a fixed diameter loop. Because of this, they cannot produce a continuous stream. The benefit is that we can produce protons of different energies, making them more adaptable to different patients' needs.